You need an email address. So if a consumer doesn't have an email address, that might be one of the things you want to ask them when they come in, because if they don't, you can help them apply for one. Of course, it doesn't take any amount of time at all, and it's free, but you want to make sure that everybody has an email address that comes into you, because especially now, even if it's not remote, more and more jobs you're applying for online, and they're going to ask for your email. And job search sites specifically, for example, like ZipRecruiter, they're going to send an email for you to confirm. So not only do you need to have an email, you need to check it. The other thing most of them are going to ask for is a resume. They're often going to ask for you to upload your resume, and then they'll also ask for you to fill in your experience, which I find very annoying. But hey, if you're applying for a job, you don't really have a whole lot of choice. So you'll need an email address, you need a resume, you'll need a phone number where the employer can contact you. And that's a question I had for all of you, because I noticed that a number of your consumers don't have phones. So what do you do in that case?
Mail them letters.
No, but what do they do if they're applying for a job when they ask for a phone number?
Oh, I don't know.
Because if somebody applies for a job with me, I'm not going to mail them a letter.
I suppose they would have to go get a phone.
Well, that might be something that you would like, all of you would like to discuss with your clients to find, if somebody doesn't have a phone and they're applying for a job, what's their plan for being able to get messages? You come in, you apply for a job, and I think, oh my gosh, Melissa is great. I want to hire this woman. How do I get hold of you? If you don't have a phone, what's your plan for employers being able to contact you? So some places say like a Center for Domestic Violence or a homeless shelter, they might have a message phone, but employers call up and it says Voc Rehab. And a lot of people don't know what Voc Rehab is, really. I mean, they're just thinking of your kids in rehab. So they may automatically decide, oh, well, we're not interested in that person. And it's kind of a vicious cycle. Like if you don't have a phone, it's hard for you to get employers to call you back. And it's hard for you to get a phone if you don't have a job. So that might be something for you to consider, is if your program could have a phone number where they could, the employers could leave messages. But it's, do you all have any ideas for this? Because it really is an issue for people, how they could get a job if they don't have a phone and they can't be contacted. So that's the third thing they'll need is a phone. So you need an email address that you actually check. a resume, a phone number where they can contact you, and references. Most of them will ask for references. And that's one thing that I know Voc Rehab is very good about, writing really good letters for people. Because when I'm hiring somebody, if I don't know them and I'm not going to meet them in person, one thing to go by is their references. So, like I said, if they don't have an email address, the Voc Rehab counselor can help get one. It just takes a few minutes. It's free. If they don't have a phone, they need to think about not just a message number. This is a funny thing. I heard it at Canar once, and it stuck with me. The message number has to be somebody reliable. And this is the director from a tribal VR program, and she said that she would ask people for a message number and they would give her one. And she would say, let's say you got underpaid or your reimbursement wasn't enough and I had a check for you, who should I call? And then people would a lot of times change the number. Oh, no, don't call that girlfriend, call my mom. So you want somebody super reliable for that message number. And again, maybe if they don't have anybody super reliable, it can be the Voc Rehab office.